This episode's FDR shoutout goes to JB and Anne McDonald. Leave a comment down below to have a chance for a shoutout in the next episode. Make sure you're subscribed. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Fish Tank Review.
I'm done. Done, dude.
You. I'm your host Chris, you're watching Fish for Thought, the channel where we review fish tanks submitted by you and crappy fish tanks I find on Reddit and people sent to me every Monday, so stop asking me when's the next review. Now before we get into it, I'm going to sponsor myself with a Patreon shoutout. First of all, big thank you to all the patrons who've been sticking with me this whole time. There are some patrons out there who have been my patrons since I was 1k subs. Can you imagine that early on of an investment from 1k to now still being my patron at 120k? That's ridiculous. And to this day, nothing even comes close. Patreon remains the best place you can support this channel. And the best thing about it is, even if you just have $1 or $2 to spare, because of the power of crowdfunding, that still means a whole world of difference to this channel. Plus, you get some cool perks along the way. Link in the description. Please go check it out. Thank you so much. From a bad taxidermy group on Facebook. I mean, even good taxidermy groups freak me the heck out. I can't imagine what a bad taxidermy group looks like. This fish is forever in a bad place. Whoa, okay, that's the first time I've seen a fish taxidermy. Can we call it that? How do you taxidermize a fish? I'm pretty sure the core element of taxidermy is different for a fish, because instead of scooping out the insides, you can't actually do that. It's way too hard. You basically preserve it in this liquid so that it doesn't break down. I'm just guessing here. I've not done any research into this crap. Spooky AF. I don't want anything taxidermized. But this is like an amber effect. You know how you find those ambers sometimes? Just rocks, but are actually hardened tree sap from eons ago. And sometimes they trap little bugs in it, and you can kind of see the bugs if the amber is a good enough clarity or whatever. This is basically the same thing. They just took a clear sort of preserving liquid that solidifies, I'm guessing, that kind of resembles water, and the fish is put into it, and they fashion it into a car gear shift. Great. I just have to say, that's kind of morbid, you know? If I had that in my car and then one of my friends, they come into the passenger seat, they'll be shocked. They'll be pretty surprised. I don't know if we'll still make that trip. Likewise, if I go into the passenger seat of some person, one of my friends, and I see this, I don't know, man. That's questionable behavior. Because every time you do anything, go outside, go on a road trip, whatever, you're reminded of this dead fish that you're continuously in pretty close proximity with. Like, you're moving the stick shift. It's kind of warm in your hands. I don't know, man. I don't know about this one. The aquascape, though, is something else, you know? That is 10 out of 10, marvelous, ADA approved, yes. ISCPL rank 1, yep. Hopefully in a better place. Rest in peace, Austin and Post. Like Post Malone? Or did they die like at the same time? What's going on? They kicked a bucket at the same time, I guess. They're like, nope, we're done with this. Let's go, homie. We going up to fishy heaven. This is hilarious because you see the similarities between the two enclosures and it just speaks volumes of why these fish died. Look, the water level, okay, you see that line? That is a perfect example because it's clearer in that tank. The water level started at that faded watermark line, and now it's gone down. Now those tanks, evaporation doesn't happen very fast. So the fact that the water had evaporated by that much of a margin means that there has not been any maintenance, not been any water changes, not even a fill up, literally burning themselves to death with the waste that they produce, the ammonia that's burning their gills, ammonia poisoning for both of these setups. I'm truly wondering, do they not know that there's something that they're doing wrong that's causing their fish to die? Post Malone is a good guy. Why would you do him like this? This fish tank is sent in by Winona Moore, and apparently this is their first fish tank. You gotta be kidding me, right? How's that even fair? My first fish tank was one of the fish tanks on Crappy Aquarium. This is a pretty darn good masterpiece. First tank? How much research did you do? You blasted me out of the water with the amount of research you did and the amount I did back then. And I did a lot. Man, some people are just born with talent, okay? This is not fair. Imagine using OcoStone and that much OcoStone in your first aquascape, in your first fish tank. Imagine having split substrate like that and a moss carpet with a Vallisneria backdrop. What's going on here? There's no way this is your first one. Are you serious? Okay, I'm inclined to believe you. I'm not gonna say I don't believe you because That's mean. What's your secret, Winona? If you see this, comment below. How can we improve like you? How can we get that strong start? 4.25 out of 5. Keep it up. When someone knows how to take care of fish and has the money to, but they still put them in small tanks. You truly are the lowest scum in history. I have to admit, I'm a huge anime fan. Can't get into JoJo. I tried 3 times to get into JoJo because one of my friends is crazy about JoJo. I can see the charm. It's funny at moments, but I guess it's just not my type of anime. I have pretty particular tastes in anime, and even I don't know what makes me like a certain anime. Usually the animation soundtrack has to be on point, and also the plot and character development. It's hard to pinpoint. I don't know. This tank is sent in by Drago Colossus 1. Tank kind of matches the name. Look at that piece of wood. It looks like a little dragon. You got some plants that are glowing red, kind of like the dragon's head. Straight bars, bro. Hold me back. Super hot fire. I think my favorite aspect of this tank, though, is the Oko stone laid a little bit flatter on the bottom. That rockscape is clean. 4.3 out of 5. Keep it up. This tank is sent in by Fizzy. It's a taller, smaller nano tank sort of thing. And you got this piece of wood that grows around and out of the water. And then you got this immersed feature. I think that is a live plant, and it might be related to aloe vera. I've seen it a few times, I just don't know what it is, but I love the color, I love the texture. It's white and it's got all these little curls coming out. Super neat. Can always appreciate a good immersed feature in a fish tank. And you plant it around and on the piece of wood. Pretty nice, good technique there. No crazy stocking options, no betta in here, even though some people might think that's good enough a size for a betta. I'm glad you didn't think so, because it definitely is a little too small. 4.2 out of 5, keep it up. Special shout out to their inability to keep the tank above halfway filled. Oh, come on, man. What is with people and not filling their tanks all the way up? I've seen 75% filled. I've seen 25, less than 10%. 50% seems to be the average median, especially with crappy fish tanks with goldfish. Now it checks out because the person doesn't know how to keep fish, doesn't know what they're doing. And that's why you see these half-filled tanks. It's like these people are tripping on acid when they're filling up their tanks. They're like holding the bucket, approaching the tank, and they're like, I can't get to the tank. It's like right in front of them. Like if someone was to walk into the room and see them, they would be inches away from the fish tank, holding the bucket and struggling to move forward because they're so high up on acid. Not a personal experience. I would never dare to do acid. I don't know what would happen to me. But some dude in one of my class in colleges was sharing his experience tripping on acid and at the grocery store and how he's not able to reach any. He was just trying to get a bag of chips and he's like, why is it continuing to go away from me? And it must have looked hilarious to everyone who was watching him. Same thing with people who can't fill up their fish tank. Just assume they're all tripping on acid. This episode's bonus secret comment is isopod. Grace Schlafer sent in this tank. Looks like a crown tail betta, looks quite healthy. Pretty basic tank, maybe on the smaller side, but you got a solo betta fish. I can't complain too much about that. This is miles better than a lot of other fish tanks. Now I feel a little scared for your plants because you got some plants in there that are very heavy root feeders, including the two Amazon swords. And that substrate just looks like black inert substrate. So if you don't want your plants to die out in a few weeks, I highly suggest switching your substrate into something with nutrients. You can even dirt the tank if you want, but let's be honest, Amazon swords will not do too well in the long term in a small tank like this. Try some small to medium sized cryptocorian species. I think you'll love it much more than Amazon swords in this case. 3.4 out of 5, keep it up. Gotta make sure to keep that pleco to water ratio high. Oh, I love this sassy caption. Sarcasm plus 100, let's go. It's like ordering a steak and getting mostly mashed potatoes. So the mashed potatoes become the main and the steak becomes the side. Same thing here, you got a fish tank or you got a pleco tank. Okay, let's move on before I ruin it. Pleco, goldfish, fake plants, bad fish owner, bad tank. It's just oozing out into it. Just all three of them at the same time. Let's go. What kind of cup is that? What company makes that? What kind of person uses that cup? Clearly, whoever this is has given up on life. And if you've given up on your own life, how can you care for the life of other animals? Man, drink some water, bro. Drink some tea. I got some Earl Grey over here, feeling fancy and white. By the way, if you have a favorite tea or have a tea that you want me to try, leave it in the comments below. Right now, I'm in the process of weaning myself off of coffee, which is going great actually, and I'm looking for new tea. I do have some teas at home that I'm rotating through, like matcha and Earl Grey and some other teas. Right now my favorite is Pu'er, which is this very unique Chinese tea. It's been my favorite since as long as I can remember. It's really good, so I actually implore you to try that tea. It's very soothing, warming, and supposed to be really good for you. So you know how some sins are unforgivable? What? How you getting a message from God? Cheap goldfish bowls near me. So you're saying if I just type this into the Google search bar, God might message me as well? It is forgivable. You put a goldfish in a bowl. Just don't do it again. Possibly worse than that betta in a light bulb, I bring you 4 goldfish in a dirty light bulb. All right, everyone, save this picture, okay? In your arsenal of memes. I don't know. Am I the only one who has like a folder where I can just take some memes that are relevant to the situation? No, just me. Okay, save this into your folder because whenever one of your friends has a bad idea, you can just show this picture because this is the epitome of an example of a bad idea in real life. Idea is portrayed by the light bulb and the bad idea is portrayed by the fact that the light bulb is being used as a fish tank for 4 goldfish. Now, this is fake and I'll tell you why it's fake. It's because there's no angelfish in there. Remember the golden rule, the golden ratio combo rule? 4 goldfish and an angelfish. There's no way this person put 4 goldfish in there and forgot the angelfish. Come on, that's impossible. Right, Rapashi? Yeah. Rapashi agrees. Photoshopped. This tank is sent in by Caesar Aquatics. Just look at the colors. They're popping off the screen, baby. Got a nice selection of plants, some woodscape, some floaters up top. You got some artificial decor here and there, but kind of reminds me of like a fallen ruins or like Mayan temple thing. So it's not too bad. At least you don't have like, I don't know, a Barbie doll in the middle of your tank or some SpongeBob decor. Solo betta fish with some otocinclus. 4.4 out of 5. Keep it up. Definition of this sub. Literally a crappy fish tank. A fish tank that is meant to, you get it. And this wraps up the episode. Welcome to the end of the video. Thank you for sticking around, giving watch time to this video and the channel, boosting algorithms, analytics, I don't know, just it's good to watch the whole video. So thank you so much for your support. The secret comment of this video is Endler's Life Bearers. Now don't forget to look for the bonus secret comment somewhere in the video. Hopefully this week's FTR started your Monday off right, and if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe. There'll be more videos to come, and don't forget to get your hands wet.